welcome back to Daytime Live. This is Nisha's favorite section.
Yes. Well,
this is static. But this is Daytime Chat, and the topic for today, should you police your relationship? Should you security guard your relationship?
Yes, you should.
Should you immigration officer your relationship?
Yes.
And I don't think you should.
I know you don't.
I think you should. There should be some boundaries, but we have Tara and Hannah to tell us all about it because, you know, you're going to fill us in.
Yes. Hannah, should you police your relationships?
I don't think you should. I think that if you find yourself in a position where you should, then you're not supposed to be in that position in the first place. You have to question other things more than just finding out what's going on in the phone. You have to question, why do I feel like I need to police this person? So if you feel like you need to police your relationship, I don't think you're in a
good relationship.
Stable relationship to begin with.
But is it not wisdom though to just keep, I think there's something in Proverbs for all you lovely church going persons out there that says a good woman knows the state of her household, you know, knows what's going on.
Yes.
So isn't it wisdom just to be mindful of, okay, darling is over here, so he should be back here, and why is he late here, and da-da-da. Tara?
I think I agree a little bit with both of you guys' opinion.
Don't be on the fence, Sarah.
No. I'm going to be a little bit diplomatic. So I think the real question would be, how do you define police in a relationship, first of all? Because I definitely agree with you. If you find yourself in a situation where you're uncomfortable and you have to be putting across so much efforts and to actually check if this person or this life partner is
where they are,
what they said.
You
shouldn't really be there. But at the same time, we're human beings and we make mistakes and things happen and life happens.
You'll never know. So we all agree. We're all leveled right there,
we're
right?
We're not leveled.
Now I want to go to...
They are leveled.
I want to... You never leveled enough.
No,
but I want to touch on the boundaries, because there should be some mutual boundaries that you share, which would lead to you not questioning whether or not, you know, why do I feel this way? Mm-hmm. Mutual boundaries in a sense of, all right, then, you know, you always trust. The trust level should always be at a certain level.
Yes.
You know, we just repeat that.
Yeah.
But, and there should also be a sense of... I don't want to say... compromising all the time,
right,
but a sense of understanding each other. So you don't, yeah, so you don't really feel that way. I don't know if you're not following me.
So you don't feel clustered.
You don't
and
feel
like somebody's
clustered.
Watching
yes.
over your back all the time.
Trapped in.
And you have certain operations. You don't go out too late without messaging. Don't allow
yeah.
you to think
so
why you're
saying they have yeah. rules in the relationship.
Yes,
have some guidelines. Have some guidelines and stay within those guidelines. But what I want to ask you guys, so I know both of you have Instagram, you have Facebook and stuff
yes.
like that. Are you aware of who your partner is or is not liking? Honestly now, because you guys are being all diplomatic, have you put yourself in a position where you're aware, okay, my boyfriend just liked Tara 27 pictures.
Yes.
Do you know? Tara, you just threw that one.
Sometimes I know, but it's not like intentional. Like I'll just like be using Instagram off his phone or doing his phone to do something. Not like
so you
policing.
Happen to just pick up his phone.
So like I will see like, or we follow mutual people, so I will see where his name says that likes this. But it's not like I'm going out to say, oh my God, whose picture did he like or something like that. But it just comes across so that I have an idea. But I don't. To me, that's not a big deal.
So you're okay. You go home and you find out that your boyfriend has liked all of Tara's pictures.
Well, no,
that you get home
no,
and have
no, I mean, like,
75
all
likes from the same one person?
Yeah.
I mean, like,
right?
all of that.
You'd be okay
yeah,
with that?
Yeah. No, I wouldn't be okay,
okay
with
then.
This. But I know I'm, you know, I'm not, like, clueless and, you know, naive. But I know that he knows other female friends. And so I don't expect him to go on Instagram and ignore his
what
friend's
I'm saying is, what if he liked 27 of that one friend's picture? Is that a problem?
No.
Yes.
So that is
yes,
a problem.
That's
what I'm saying,
what she
guys.
Said,
be honest.
No, but her relationship seemed quite peachy and nice. Nobody not like
my relationship very peachy and nice.
And Tara, for you, though, Tara, how would you respond to a situation like that?
I think it's based. All right. So in my past relationships,
yes,
I was on the phone. He went to the bathroom on the phone. Check it.
Checking his
put
phone.
Put it back here. Put
I
it back down
you.
When he came. No, I used to do that.
Oh,
but I
that's
sorry.
The truth because that's
I know that's the truth. A lot of females and
a
males.
A lot of people do that.
Yeah, we've been through that, and I've been through it. Now I'm at a place where I'm so thankful and grateful for the confidence that I have within my relationship. Mm-hmm. In Jamaica, we say we can't swear for nobody, and I'll still say that, but I'm very close to it.
Okay.
To be honest.
Okay, I don't like the diplomatic.
No, I'm being serious. I'm being serious.
All right, we're moving on. Yeah. So let's say hubby says, okay, baby, I'm going out this evening with
Janice,
a work colleague. Oh, no. He's going out on his own. He comes home and you're picking up his trousers off the floor and a receipt falls out. You look at the receipt, you see that it's...
I took the highway.
Crewbar or something.
Yeah,
do
my
you
car,
check
crewbar.
The receipt to see if there's one mojito or two?
As in for save woman drink?
To see, he said he's going out by himself.
Yeah, he said by himself.
Exactly.
Last time he spoke.
So do you check it to ensure? Or no, you
I
just...
I would just like check the top to see if I should throw it away or like put it somewhere for him. But I wouldn't like go into details to see what he bought. I would just like check the top.
I would
to
go
see
into
if
details.
It's worth
I would go into details.
Or
but I mean, come on,
I would
there's
go
so
into
many
details,
things that you know. The overthinking thing. Go ahead.
I would go into details, but my boyfriend and I we have a very open-minded relationship. Meaning we talk. We're
your
best
very
friends
open
first.
Relationship.
Yes. We talk about everything. We're best friends first. That's the first thing, and that's very important. So if he, and it can be a case where he didn't tell me that he was going out with somebody, it slipped his mind or somebody joined him afterwards, I would just mention it, I'll question him.
So
but
what
babe, why, no, he's fine with it, that's what I'm saying. Babe, why are there five mojitos over the 3-hour period? You can't have five
that's
mojitos.
That's a weird question.
Thank you.
No, and he's so the thing, we're good with
but
it.
But pause a second, what just came out uh-huh. is that we do, you see, when we say things like policing your relationship, uh-huh. everyone gets a little bit like, oh, I would never,
yeah,
oh my
exactly
gosh. But when you unpack it.
Everybody does it.
You do it. Everybody yeah. does it. You have to. And to be honest, for me personally, except for Joel, he doesn't do it, but he don't know.
Look, no, I'm looking at the lady with the camera.
The lady with the camera. Right? Yeah, well, maybe not that far, but no. maybe, you know.
I just think there should be guidelines. That's the most important thing.
What?
I just think there should be guidelines. I don't think there should be
what
guidelines
do you mean,
in a sense of... Guidelines in the sense of... I'm basically agreeing with Hannah.
She's agreeing
you don't
with
want
me.
To, no, she's not.
Well,
don't
she
put
did
her,
what
don't
I
put her.
Just on the line.
You need to be at a level in your relationship, and these are basic things that you would
well,
notice.
Pause a second. Are you saying that if you trust, because he's saying that if you trust somebody, you won't do that. So you're saying you can't trust someone and still look out for your own.
I mean, eventually you're going
self.
To still look out for yourself, but the details that some people got, the extent,
so
the devil is
in
like,
you and I were together, sorry.
Checking if I drink 3 mojitos.
So if I asked you that question, yeah. I said, babe, I'm wearing 5 mojitos. You're there with somebody else? Wait.
Yes,
wait.
May I go drink some mojitos?
No,
go on, Tara,
the only issue you should have if you said yes. The only issue you have is if you were to say yes and I have a problem with it. If you said yes, I don't have a problem.
No, but again,
that's my point. Because I trust.
That's not too far from me and my relationship.
No, you see, and that's why ladies nowadays, you have to do better than you're doing. You have to police your relationship. You have to ensure that you're aware, not stalking. You see these naughty words you're using? You have to ensure that you know what's going on. Like, for example, if your boyfriend starts talking about Tara. Yes, Tara. Who's Tara?
Who's Tara?
All of a sudden, you're talking about Tara. So you just go, I trust him. Yes, yeah, so Tara.
No,
maybe I'm
gonna
go
trust him, but
Tara.
I still ask.
You have to ask.
You know, all this boils down to jealous, babe. Remember everyone, Hurt Bear was trending on Twitter the other day. This is jealous,
I know what
babe.
He said.
Jealous,
why you didn't
babe.
Just go about your business.
I will still ask about different. That person who is being mentioned all the time. Or I use his phone and I see. I ask.
Because asking and looking doesn't mean that you're not trusting.
No, not at all.
Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah,
it doesn't mean that. So you can still...
cause some problem in the relationship, I guess. But at the same time, as I said before, there are certain levels. You're in a relationship at the first stage. You'll know if this is somebody that you'll probably feel comfortable with. Sharing certain things or somebody who you might have a trust level heightened or whatever, because you really don't want to feel that you need to question everything, and that's the first premise where Hannah push out. I really agree with that, and
I want
think
to tell
once,
you something.
Once that's good and set, you should have no problem.
The thing about it is, because you guys aren't being honest again, but that's fine. I'll be honest. I'll be the honest one on the table. I know a lot of persons who have, not a lot of persons, but a few people who have said to me that they found out that their partner was in a relationship with other people because they were checking something on Facebook. because they were checking up.
So on, via Facebook.
You understand what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah. So then on Facebook they found out, and you have friends that would say, you know that I saw a girl update her relationship status and it says she's dating somebody.
That was not
so. They have to cover their
tracks. It's important for you to cover your tracks, to be wise. Not
wait,
go crazy and
about covering our tracks.
Listen, covering your tracks.
Is that what we're talking about?
Covering your tracks.
Covering your tracks. There's so much to talk about, but that's where we end today for chat, because we'll chat. Daytime Live will be right back.